Thank you very much to invite me to introduce about our religion dialogue and to present some information about the Muslims in Ukraine. But excuse me, my English language not good. I prepare my speech using Russian language. But when I came, they told me that nobody can translate. Now, I translated, but I will try to speak. Before starting, I want to give some correction information about terminology in Islam. The Islam is not the new religion and or the last religion. The Islam, that's the name of the name Islam, that's the name of the religion of all the prophets, the name of the religion of angels, the religion which acceptable by God, that's one, that's the religion of all the prophets. That's, but the Arabic name of, for this religion, that's Islam. We believe in God. In Arabic, we speak Allah. And we speak. We believe that the God that's not similar to anything. He's created the all. He exists without starting and without end. And he's not body, not volume, and he's not have any similar. And all the prophets, they have the one way. All their have the right way. But the law, that's different. The last law acceptable by Allah, that's the, in Islam, we speak Shariat. This is the different. But the religion of the all, that's one. That's what I want to explain for everybody. About the extremism. Many people speak about the extremists and we are against the extremists and the sects, but nobody explains what the meaning of the extremism. According to the Islam, when we speak about the Muslim community, the extremists, that's the, a few group who make another understanding for our religion. And the majority of the Muslim people, through the time, they have the one explanation and the one meaning about Islam. This is, we speak the wasatiyya or the middle understanding for Islam. And who not acceptable this one, that they organize their group. That are the sects. For example, at all the time, all the Muslim community, the majority of the Muslims, they have one ideology about the understanding of Islam. That's the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. But some group have another idea about the Islam, and they explain Islam according to their political position, and they organize a new line. Like, for example, the Wahhabi groups, they believe that if somebody wants to ask the God through the prophet, they must kill him, because for them he is not believing man. And for the Hizb al-Ikhwan, for example, brother Muslims, they think that if one law don't use according to Islam, they must kill you. This is the group which we speak that sect, not the Islam, the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. That's what, like example, when we speak about the terrorism or the extremism, because they go out the middle understanding of the Muslim community until all the time. About our position in Ukraine, I will try to speak, but please patient, because this is the first time I speak lecture in English language. Okay. Speaking on the need for interreligious dialogue, it is important to note that Islam as a religion and the Muslim world as a whole in recent decades seen as a danger. In wide use includes terms such as Islamic terrorism, Islamic threat. We find only with Islam. Nobody speaks the Christian terrorism or extremism, but anything about the Muslim community, they speak that Islamic terrorism or Islamic extremism, and other similar expressions. Obviously, the formation toward Muslims' enemy image beneficial certain political forces but it is temporary and illusory benefits, and ultimately a dead end. Since we live in one world, and inevitably some problems, this is a problem of all others. And the more this approach is unacceptable for countries of the former socialist camp, most of them, the composition of the population are multinational and multi-religious. Therefore, speaking about the development of interfaith dialogue, you should first recognize the need to remove the false myths and stereotypes about Islam and Muslims perceived not as threat and terrorist, but as full partners and participant in solving many social problems of peace and sustainable development of society. In connection with the foregoing, I consider it necessary to allocate three questions without which it is impossible to develop effective interfaith dialogue. First, this hotfix is a public opinion about our religion. The need for fair and objective attitude towards Islam as a creed, doctrine of separation of our ideological layers and the political speculations introduced by some destructive tendencies and extremist sects who try to use Islam as a cover for her often criminal activity. Second, the formation of the balanced state policy in the field of interfaith relations based on the responsibility of the whole society and not on the desire to achieve short-term political goals and propaganda effects develop of comprehensive and consistent position of state and government on the issue of interfaith cooperation designed for long term. Third, we must pay special attention to the role of media in Islamic themes and shaping a public opinion about Islam. This division is rather arbitrary, since all these issues are closely linked and it is rather three aspects of the same problem. Therefore, one of our goals is to teach society clearly distinguish ideology sects on the doctrine of Islam and separate these two conspects. About this, religion administration of Ukrainian Muslims has been working for over 20 years. During this time, we are seeing a positive trend as representatives of other religions to learn accurate information about Islam have become increasingly cooperate with the Muslims based on the common value of all confessional society. In Ukraine, according to Rose estimates, there are about 2 million Muslims, about 4%. They are representatives of different nationalities, mostly Turkish-speaking, but there are also Arabs, Persians, Caucasians, and Slavic Muslims. Islam was spread in Ukraine during the time of Kievan Rus from the 9th century. From the 15th century, Muslim populations are most concentrated in the southeast region. However, in 1944, the Crimean Tatars, who were one of the many ethnic groups professing Islam, were deported almost completely, resulting in Islam in Ukraine has disappeared from the public sphere or religious life. becoming a matter of personal faith, the basis of domestic customs and rituals. According to the reports of commissioners of religious affairs, the late 20th century and before Ukraine gained its independence in 1991, there was no one registered Muslim community. Thus, despite the absence of registered Muslim communities, continental Ukraine without the Crimea Peninsula. At the beginning of 1991 in Ukraine lived quite a lot of Muslims. In Kyiv lived mainly Volga Tatars, to a lesser extent the Bashkirs, the representatives of the peoples of the Caucasus and Central Asia. Revival of Islam in Ukraine began in the early 1990s with the acquisition of Ukrainians' independence. In September 1992 was officially registered the first in the independent history of Ukraine Islamic organization on a national scale, the Religious Administration of Ukrainian Muslims, RAUM. Moreover, it should be noted that unlike other organizations which are built on the basis of ethnic and religious nature, RAUM unites Muslims of all nationalities throughout Ukraine. From the very beginning, our efforts were aimed at rallying the multinational community of Muslims of Ukraine, teach religion knowledge, as well as countering the proliferation of extremist sects in Ukraine. And we try to teach our Muslims in our country, not to send outside, because when we send outside, maybe some students will accept new ideology or political position. Why we try to leave our imams in European country and studied in this one? Why we open the Islamic University and have legalization of our diploma with the Al-Azhar? RAUM is a member of the All-Ukrainian Council of Churches and Religious Organizations since the formation in 1996 at the initiative of the President of Ukraine as an interfaith representative body under the State Committee of Religious Affairs. In recent years, Ukraine has been a marked tendency to involve religious organizations to address various social problems. The Religious Administration of the Ukrainian Muslims take an active part in the discussion of issues related to the adoption of law relating to religious organizations. Thus, representatives of our administration included in a working group to draft a new version of the law of Ukraine on freedom of conscience and religious organizations. The question arose about the need to identify and compile a list of totalitarian sects and radical extremist organizations religious nature with the introduction of a legal ban on the registration and activities in Ukraine. Conclusion on the draft law of Ukraine on freedom of conscience and religious organizations, which were given by the Venice Commission on the basis of comments by George Malinverini, a committee member in Switzerland, and Louise Leon Christian, expert Belgium, contained no criticism of the proposed complex Ukrainian examination, which confirmed that in Europe are sensitive to the measures taken, both in Ukraine and in other countries, aimed at enhancing the protection of society from the destructive influence of currents, including the dangers of terrorism. Important place in the religion administration takes the cooperation with the Ministry of Defense in Ukraine, of Ukraine, as served in the Ukrainian army and the Muslims are in need of the protection of their religious right in the military services. Tool for this collaboration was the Council for Pastoral Care of the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine, which includes a representative of the Muslims in Ukraine. Religion administration is also actively involved in initiatives to counter the rise of intolerance and discrimination, conflict prevention on the national and religious grounds. Ukrainian Muslims are actively involved in various roundtables on xenophobia and discrimination and are part of the working group for the effective exchange of information and strengthen cooperation between the enforcement agencies, government, religious, and community organizations to prevent xenophobia, racism, and incitement of ethnic hatred. Decision on the formation of this body was made at a roundtable held at the initiative of the Security Service of Ukraine in May 2013. All activities of the Council, all our effort is to give people the opportunity to form a correct idea about Islam. Muslims must be not perceived as extremists, but as worthy representative of people and the state in which they live. Thus, due to the recent event that took place in Ukraine in late 2013, early 2014, you can see how interfaith dialogue strengthened Ukrainian society who stood in front of the socio-political threats and challenges. Back in September 2013, as part of religion administration with all Ukrainian Council of Churches and religious organizations, acted in support of Ukrainians' course towards European integration, saying that the future of Ukraine naturally caused our historical roots and an independent state in the range of free European peoples. We as Muslims of Ukraine, within it is on competence, within a competence, together with the heads of religious denominations, have made every possible effort to prevent the division of society on ethnic grounds. As has been said for centuries, a multinational Ukraine, but for all of its existence, was not observed acute conflict over cultural differences. Despite this, there are forces that want to rekindle animosity using this factor. So the example of the recent events was an attempt to provoke confrontation between East and West Ukrainian using not only political views, but also cultural and national differences. In the most critical moment of social confrontation, leaders of the Muslim religious and the other confessions spoke from a position of national reconciliation. The unacceptability of violence, preservation of inter-ethnic and inter-religious peace in Ukraine. In its communique, heads of all confessions put forward a number of requirements, called for an immediate end to the bloodshed and on both sides, a request for an urgent meeting with the ex-president of Ukraine, Viktor Yanukovych, and the opposition leaders, as well as the requirement to stop use the religion in the political technologies. We also call on all citizens of Ukraine to the preservation of peace and the integrity of the Ukrainian state. A chapter denomination held several meetings with the president on the opposition and the opposition, where religious leaders have offered the help in resolving the conflict by all available means within the jurisdiction. It was during this hard time for our state, multi-religious Ukrainian society has demonstrated its solidarity in the face of the threat. We are pleased to see the result of their labor as the years of our work over the union representatives of different peoples living in Ukraine, we were not in vain. Thank you.
Thank you.
Excuse me, but I tried.
It's okay. English was absolutely clear, at least to me. Native speaker will tell you more about that, but it was absolutely clear. Well, these last sentences were good words for all of us because, you know, they remind to us that interreligious dialogue can be in just in the moment of the crisis a good tool for creating a new link between changing identities or changing unstable identities and traditions, and whatever could be the tradition or the sum of the tradition, the cultural tradition of a given country, the dialogue among the most important values of human beings should be first aid and a sure port in which recreate conditions for cooperation and peace. So I think this should be considered as a word of optimism, not only for the Ukraine case, but generally speaking for all the regions of the world where conflicts about identities and divisions are particularly, you know, evident these days. But I don't want to take time to comments and questions, please.
But please, slowly.
Yeah.
Understand.
Yeah. Slowly but clear questions from one of the students on ICD. Please go ahead. Thanks.
Thank you so much. Privet. My name is Masmutau Shashtot Fritzberger. I am from the former Polish minority of Volhynia, now living in Denmark. What has happened in Crimea is something that, to me, has been going on for other times before that in the Ukrainian history. But what kind of role can the Muslim community and the all Ukrainian organization for churches and religious organizations, what kind of role can these communities play in terms of aiding the fugitives from Crimea? Thank you.
We can probably bridge other points to this crucial question about the role. Yes, please, Mr. Ambassador. Yeah.
thank you so much for your presentation. It really gave me a clear picture. As a former part of the Soviet Union, your country, how is the situation of secularism in your country? Thank you.
About the crime, that's the problem not only for the Muslim community, that's the problem of the all people who live in crime. And I think that the solution that's between the East and the West, not in Ukraine. About the secular, any government speak about himself, they choose the secular way. But when they want to be, when they organize the election, they try to use the religion. And when they have some problem, they try to ask the representative of the religion organization. This is the problem. We try to be pure, separately and independently, without the political conflicts. And for us, that's not easy for the Muslims, because we are the only about 4%. When they organize the Orange Revolution, for example, and when they change the situation to another way, and after that to make a new kind of revolution, somebody asks you, where are you? You are here or here? We are Muslim community, and we are different. And anyone, maybe in one family, two person have two a kind of political position. We are representative of the Muslim community for religion, education, and knowledge, not for political position. This is our way. And we try to keep this way separately. Every Muslim have a different position, but we try to join all together. And that's not easy for us, because our community is that's representative of different nationality, different culture, different languages. That's not easy to join all together.
Okay, please, one more.
My name is Sylvia, and I am a student of ICD. I would like, first of all, to congratulate you for your first speech in English. It was, I think, very welcomed, and it was very well carried. And secondly, but even more importantly, I want to express gratitude for your statements in the end of your speech regards the reconciliation of the society in Ukraine and the separation between religion and the political sphere. I think this is a very humanistic and very decent and contemporary argument that you make. My question would go back to your statement regarding your relationship with the youth, with the young people, that you say we try to tell them not to go outside, not to be influenced by other sects or directions. And I was just curious, what exactly did you mean by that? Did you mean that you want to inspire the young people to stay in Ukraine and make a future for themselves in the country and just participate to the Ukrainian and the Muslim life in the region? That was my question. Thank you.
We speak about the Islamic knowledge. That's not necessary to study the basically information about Islam to go outside. We can teach in European country to understand Islam without the Arabic language. And when you have the basically information, you can go out. But the problem of the different countries is they sent their children anywhere to study Arabic and to know about Islam, and without any control. And somebody come back and come with a different ideology. with different political position. Why we speak that we organize our education in Ukraine? That's not to speak everybody no go outside, but they must understand the situation and the multi-ethnic cultural in Ukraine, and to according Islam, how we can use our knowledge to live and integrated with this community. This is the goals which we have. But about the secular, in Ukraine they speak that secular country, but after the Orange Revolution, they decided to study Christian ethic, moral in school. But that's secular school, but teach the one kind of religion, like moral. That is, we ask the government, that's not right, according to the constitution. But the fact that somebody try because they have the majority possibility to do everything. And that's one of the problem in Ukraine, because the religion, Christian religion, that's not one. They have two Orthodox church, or three, and they have the Catholics, and have the Greek Catholics, and the Baptist, and Evangelists, and the others. That's not easy to study, to teach one kind of religion about the cultural education.